say a Latino in Nevada or Arizona.
And when the media wasn't defending or downplaying the remarks, they were downright ignoring them, showing you just how much damage control Biden continues to put his campaign in. Now, late last night, the Biden campaign tried to clean up the remarks. But here's the thing. There's nothing Democrats can do to clean up Biden's decades of failure in the Washington swamp and his endless disasters on the 2020 campaign trail. And it's why in 88 days, we face the biggest choice election of our lifetime. Because it's not just Joe Biden and his bizarre blunders on the ballot in November. It's everything the new extreme Democratic Party stands for. Joining me now for Reaction, civil rights attorney Leo Terrell, along with Salem radio host Larry Elder. Gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us here tonight. Leo, they brought out the big guns to defend Joe Biden. They brought out the Congressman Clyburn. They brought out the mayor of Atlanta. They all tried to get out and put the spin on this thing. It just didn't fly, did it?
No, because you cannot do damage control on a racist. Joe Biden is a racist. 50 years of history of this. Last night, I predicted that they were going to roll out Jim Clyburn. Jim Clyburn came out. And you know what's insulting about that? Jim Clyburn comes out carrying Joe Biden's water and expects all black Americans, Larry and myself, Condoleezza Rice, to believe his version of what Joe Biden said. Jim Clyburn insults our intelligence because, again, he can't speak for me, he can't speak for Larry, he can't speak for black Americans, and what those other networks are doing, like MSNBC and CNN, they're doing a disservice to black Americans because the prerequisite to go on those shows, you have to be an apologist to the Democratic plantation mentality. And if Andrea Mitchell wants to interview black Americans who have different opinions, invite me, invite Larry, invite us, and we'll tell her exactly how we feel that we want to move from this Democratic mindset of extremism and we want to vote for President Trump. One last point. Jim Clyburn has no credibility. He attacks our great president by trying to make a derogatory comment about him being Mussolini, and he attacks our American soldiers by calling them Gestapo tactics. Jim Clyburn is a dinosaur. He needs to retire yesterday.
Yeah, I'm sorely disappointed in Congressman Clyburn. I've had the greatest respect for him, but those comments are so, they're just so outrageous. But Larry, these things, these comments that I hear, and especially from Joe Biden, are so patronizing. How do they strike you?
Well, of course they're patronizing, Jason. And this is the identity party that tried to act like it's not the identity party. Ayanna Pressley last year said, we don't need any more brown faces who don't want to be brown voices. We don't need any more black faces who don't want to be black voices. How is that any different than Joe Biden telling Charlemagne the God, if you don't know if you want me or Biden, you ain't really black? This is how these guys roll. Diane Watson, a congresswoman, once said of a black political Republican opponent, you're married to a white woman, you have no ethnic pride. Mark Lamont Hill, when Donald Trump got elected, invited people like Jim Brown and Steve Harvey to the White House, and he referred to them as, quote, self-promotion. That's why I did that.